could see that Krishna was ready to go and cry. And those gopis began crying. They said, "Don't leave. If you go, then our homes will become useless. Our homes will become empty like the forest. And the forest will become our homes. Our enemies will become our friends. Our friends will become our enemies. Poison will become like nectar, and nectar will become like poison. We'll die." Krishna couldn't face the gopis. He turned his face away, and he walked away with Akura. Akura took him again and put him on a chariot next to Balaram. And then those gopis, they gathered there together in that place. Rupa Goswami describes three divisions of Sudhura Prabhas, that intense separation when Krishna leaves Braj. Bhavi, Bhuta, and Bhavan. We spoke about Bhavi on Sudhura Prabhas, Vipralamba. Separation which hadn't yet taken place, but there was some rumor about it. This separation when Krishna was on the chariot and Akura was taking him away, this is known as Bhavan. Sudhura Prabhas, or that separation which is in the act of happening. The gopis, they were blocking the chariot. The poet Gopal Krishna, the Arisan poet, in his book Mathura Mangal, gives a very beautiful description of this. The gopis, they began crying to Krishna. And they told Krishna, "We've heard about you. Garga Muni has told us that previously you came in Treta Yuga and you were Ramachandra. We see that now you're acting just like Ramachandra. Just like Ramachandra left Ayodhya and went with Lakshman to the Dundak forest in the chariot of Mantra, Sumantra. So in the same way, you're taking Balaram and you're leaving Braj in the chariot of Akura. But there's some difference," the gopis told Krishna. "As Ramachandra, you were more kind because you took Sita with you. So in the same way, you should take Radharani with you now." And the gopis, they said, "We know you're just like that Ramachandra. But you're worse than Ramachandra. We've heard that in Treta Yuga, in your pastimes as Lord Ram, like a hunter, you stood behind a tree, and with your arrow, you shot Bali in the back and killed him. And he had no chance to defend himself. In Treta Yuga, you very mercilessly killed Bali. But now, in Dwarpar Yuga, you're killing thousands of Balis. Bali is a name of that monkey king. But Bali is also a Sanskrit word for young girl." And the gopis are telling Krishna, "By leaving Vrindavan, you're going to kill thousands of Balis. You're worse than Ramachandra." And the gopis, they held onto the horses of Akura. Akura had to take the horses away from the gopis with throwing themselves on the ground in front of the chariot. And Akura, seeing the face of Krishna, he realized, "If I don't go now, Krishna's going to jump off the chariot. Krishna's going to stay here." And so like someone running an obstacle course, Akura began making his chariot go very fast and going in a zigzag way so that he could take Krishna away from Vrindavan. The gopis were trying to stop that chariot. They were pleading with Nanda Maharaj, "What are you doing?" And Nanda told them, "Don't think that I'm going in a happy way. Don't think that I believe that Krishna is there somewhere. Don't think that I'm going to leave Krishna there and return alone. Don't think that I'm going to agree to stay there for a long time. I'm going to return Krishna very soon." All the gopis of Braj were wailing. Their piteous cries were echoing throughout the land of Braj. And not just the gopis, but the cows, the bulls, the calves, the deer from the forest. And all the other animals began crying and surrounding Akura's chariot.